Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome on stage Menelik Watson.
I'm worried that you're not going to fit in the chair.
I hope I don't break it.
I hope that's well made, Menelik.
Yeah, I'm all right.
£300, I believe. Yeah.
£320.
Sorry, you put a bit on. Welcome to BT City Square. Now, first and foremost, you're a big Blue. We've all got our stories about how we become City fans. What's yours?
Well, when I was growing up, all my brothers, my dad was a United fans, and you know, yeah, exactly. And they tried brainwashing me, and one day I was going through my side on my way to play basketball, and I saw this stadium in the background tucked away. And I was like, what's that? You know what I mean? And I learned that about City and learned about the history. And then from there, just ran with it and just stayed faithful.
And it's been a hard ride, mate. I mean, you've stuck with
yeah,
it.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of these people here, I mean, I'm a big City fan, but I can imagine the people out here in the cold who come every week. Do you know what I mean? And like, we've been through the hard times, you know what I mean? Battling relegation and my brother's laughing at me, you know what I mean? And I told him one day we're going to be good. And, you know, look at us now, do you know what I mean? It's come a long way.
Here we are. And how has City's profile changed? I mean, obviously you're living in America, which we'll talk about in a minute, but how's City's profile changed in America? Are you seeing more City shirts around?
Oh, yeah.
Are you flying the flag?
Oh, yeah. I mean, when I first got out there in 2009, all I would find is Man United fans, you know what I mean? People who have never been to Manchester, like, oh, I like Man United. But now, I mean, I'll ask people and they're all City fans now. I mean, I see City shirts all over the place.
Scared you, I think.
Yeah, intimidation, isn't it? Make them switch. Yeah.
Your story is incredible. Like, I'm positive one day it's going to be a film. But how does a guy from Longside end up playing in the NFL?
Well, just, you know, everything, you know, everyone from Manchester knows what Longside's like, and, you know, growing up, I always wanted something better for myself, you know, and then I tried footy, and I ended up snapping my ankle, almost losing my foot. So then when I realised I couldn't play footy anymore, I found basketball, and then from there, you know, I had dreams of always, you know, doing it professionally, and, like, from there, I just stayed dedicated and stuck with it.
And your rise, Menelik, from obviously playing basketball to featuring now in the NFL, you know, going through the college system over there very, very quickly.
Right.
That must have been so difficult to adjust to, because the difference in level must be unbelievable.
Yeah, it's a big difference, but, you know, it was dedication. You know, at the end of the day, I knew where I wanted to go. So when it was, you know, I knew that I had to study twice as hard. I knew I had to work out twice as hard. So when I did that, everything just kind of just sailed off and just moved really smoothly.
Did they tell you that you weren't tall enough for basketball?
No, they didn't. I just got too big. I got to America, man, and just started eating all the burgers and all that, you know what I mean? And then I started getting bigger, but I could still play, though. I could still play basketball. And you know, I had an opportunity to come back and play here locally for the Manchester Magic or the Giants and maybe in a little venture in Spain or France. But at the end of the day, I had an opportunity in America, and I just felt like I should maximize that opportunity. And that's when I made the decision to switch over to football, American football.
And obviously, you are, from what I believe, the highest pick British player in the NFL.
Yep.
I followed you a little bit. I'm not a stalker. You know what? To be fair, I did my view a little bit on Twitter to come down today. But how is that added pressure? I mean, obviously, you know, you're getting quite a lot of exposure from the UK.
Yeah, no, it's not even really pressure. You know, I'm sure a lot of the professional football players here can tell you, you know, if you really want to be good, you put the most pressure on yourself. So I know I'm representing an old country. So when I'm out there, I make sure I represent Manchester the right way. Do you know what I mean? And stay true to myself. And then if I stay true to myself and make expectations for myself, you know, I'll take off and, you know, the rest will be handled by itself.
And the NFL is, of course, notoriously a hard sport. Do you ever look at some of the pansies playing in the Premier League and think, you need to come over
you know,
here?
You know, a lot of Americans give me a hard time. You know, you soccer players, you dive a lot and all that. I'm like, listen, if you ever got kicked in the ankle by some of these guys, you know what I mean? That's pretty much how I snapped my foot. Do you know what I mean? I tried to stand in there while a guy was coming to tackle me, and my foot broke off. Do you know what I mean? So I understand from that standpoint, but then some of these, like, you know, Spain and all that, you know, them Spanish guys, they love to do a little dive and a little, you know what I mean, Cristiano Ronaldo stuff, do you know what I mean, all that. But I definitely understand, though, you know, where they come from, but you know, if they haven't played it, you shouldn't really talk bad about it, should they?
And just very quickly before you go, prediction for tonight?
Oh, it's a win, definitely. I mean, 2-goal minimum. I was there in New York when we played them in New York, and that was good to watch all them Chelsea fans out there walk out with their heads down. So it's the same thing again today.
Happy days. Well, it's been an absolute pleasure having you here on City Square. Good luck with your career over in the NFL. Ladies and gentlemen, Menelik Watson!